hands up. Hi guys, how are you? So today we will do the designing stuff. I'm sure you must have read the title, and if you have been following my previous live streams that I am mostly doing I have done a blogging website, you can say, and we have done two episodes of that, and it was you can say it was not very fast, that we are moving too fast in creating a website in you can say in a single live stream. Instead we was moving slowly, step by step, creating a blogging website from scratch, and till now we have just created a basic page where we have a header and the post and the footer. So before I was thinking that before we dive into creating the whole website and designing using CSS, so I was thinking that it would be a good idea if we could do some creativity over here in the Figma, and came up with new ideas how we can design the whole blogging website. Even though you are watching this live stream, I'm sure if you have any better idea, you can suggest me that too. And okay, so we will just start the designing. And guys, let me know if the sound is the music is too loud or low. I can adjust it accordingly. And yeah, just a second guys, I'm splitting my screen. I have opened multiple windows, like I have opened the Twitch chat on one side, and I have opened Discord on the next side. And since I mentioned about the Discord, you can join my Discord server if you are into, maybe if you are a developer, or if you have any if you want to talk with other people, it's a great place to hang out. I will just share the link of the Discord invite. Using this link, you can join the Discord server. Okay, so we can get started. Okay. Okay, so we are good to go now. Okay. So what we will do, we will just create a blank canvas first, and then we will see what we can came up with, and accordingly we will do some brainstorming. So I will select the desktop canvas. So I will go for I can go for iMac, because approximately my screen, my laptop screen size is approximately nearby only. So well, I think so my laptop screen size is 1320 pixel by 720 roundup. I'm not sure like on what basis we, I think we count on the base of pixel, right? Yeah. Okay, so I will go for iMac. Okay, so now we can start designing. First of all, we will create the footer. I'm sorry, we will create the header first, and then the body content, and then the footer. Or what we can do, we can create the header and the footer first, and then we can attach those elements to the top and the bottom, and then as we expand the expand the canvas, it will move accordingly. Yeah, I'm sorry guys, I was just about to sneeze. It stopped in the middle only. This is very weird. Okay, so let's start. So what we can do, so before that, before I start designing, I just want to tell that my plan for creating a blog website is that I will not create a home page or an call to action where the user will redirect to another another blogging page. So when the user will land on this page, it will this will be the page where they will see all the blog posts. Okay, so let's start. We will create a tag. Oops, it is creating a frame. We don't want a frame, we needed a tag. And by the way, if you are not sure like which tool I'm using, Figma. It is the best tool and I have been using it for a long time. I like it very much, and since it is a cloud based, all the content and most all of your work is saved online. Since they don't have any offline functionality yet, but it is they are building it. Okay, so the navbar. What we can do? Okay. So we have created this thing, and now so I have created this rectangle just for a reference. I will not use this as a kind of a background color. I'll just create a reference that this much will be the height of the actual header. So I will go for 80 for now. We can tweak it later on. And I will and the name of this blogging website is bold. So we came up with this name in our first live stream. In the first live stream of this series. We will increase the font size to maybe 25. And maybe we need some kind of a thickness. Okay, we can change the font later on. And let me create a cargo. Okay. And now we need so in the blogging page we in the blogging website we have we might have different pages like home page, that's obvious. We also need maybe a categories pages, or maybe we might need a subscribe page also. Okay, so we can add. Let me decrease the font size. So we can keep the font size maybe. So by default, if we go for a browser font size, So most of the browser, I mean most of the people use 16 font size, so we will go for maybe 18, a little bit bigger than the font size which we use for the body text. And we can use the normal font font page, and we can use text transform uppercase, and I will use the same thing over here for the title. Okay, and we also need the subscribe option. And we also need to set margins. Okay, so we got the margins. So the canvas is 1300 around, so we can do maybe 120. It is a standard amount that how much margin we want to set. We can tweak that also later on. So it is 1280. Okay. So since it is not so it is around 1300. Okay. So this is 120. This okay. So we will use 110. Come on. Okay, 110. And here also we will use 110. Okay. And now let's line it to right and to the center, vertically center. And for the so it looks I think it looks a bit weird that they are totally away from the title only, but we can tweak it in the turn also. So we're just creating a simple header in the footer first. Okay, let's group them together and rename it to header. Okay, and it looks quite weird. So if we what we do if we and remove the so it not look I mean it doesn't look that bad. We can change the font family and it will look good. Okay, so now let's create the footer. So for the footer we will use the same thing. We can this is the header. And this will be the footer. And it will be at the bottom. And it will be scaled on the both side. Okay, so footer we can do. I think they don't have options for creating I mean, for searching icons, they should have an option, inbuilt option for kind of an icon gallery. That would be really nice. But I'll just create a simple copyright icon. Okay. Stroke, we need stroke 1 pixel, or maybe we can go for 1.5. Yeah, that looks good. And now we need to just align it vertically and horizontally center. Okay, so I think it is already aligned. Maybe we can make it a little bit bolder. And since this is just a copyright thing, we need to make it just a simple thing, not very fancy. So it looks good, not that bad. Copyright. Okay, we got a copyright, and let's move it a little bit over here, and this one over here. Okay, and since this is a footer, we will decrease the font size, and obviously we need to decrease the font, I mean decrease the size of this one also. So we can use the font size 16 pixel. Okay. And okay, copyright 2018. So one thing I'm not sure about this thing, that is there some kind of a pattern that we have to add the year first or the copyright word before or after? So I'm not sure about that. And we need to do the text transform lowercase. Okay, so this one capitalize. Okay, and after that we need to add the name of the website. I think I need to decrease the size of this thing. So what's the size of this? So size is 19 pixels. So we can keep it 19 pixels only, or we can it will be hard to align vertically center if we keep it 19 pixels. So we can keep it 20. Okay. Now set it vertically center. Yeah, that looks good. Okay. We can rename it to copyright icon, and set this to copyright. Okay. And on the right side, we will need all the social media icon. Just a second, let me okay. Oops. Okay. Okay, so it looks good now. And now we need to add the icons. Okay, so let me just use the real logos of the social medias. So there's a separate, I have created a separate collection for all the icons in the Figma file. So I will just grab the icons from there. And you can follow me on Twitter. I have shared my Twitter handle on the chat. And you can also help me to run these live streams by donating few bucks a month. So what you can do, you can visit this link. I have shared the link in the chat. You can visit this link and share a few bucks. That would be really helpful, and it will help me to run the live streams. And apart from that, if you need some perks along with, if you are donating some money, and also you need some perks, what you can do, once you will join the Discord server using this link, you can join my Discord server. So once you will join the Discord server, what you do, just type donate in the general channel. You will get an attachment. I will just show you how to how does it work. So once you have joined the Discord server, so in the general channel, just type donate. And after then you have to click this link. It shows purchase rules from the server. So once you will click the link, you will be redirected to a separate page. Just a second. Okay. So you will land on this page. So what you can do, so you can select the role which you want to purchase. So currently there are two separate roles. The first one is the guest and the second one is subscriber. So in the guest role, you will get a chance to be with me on air. So as I am talking live on the live stream, so what you can do, what you will get, you will be able to join this voice channel. Since I am speaking right now, you will be able to see some kind of an bubble over here. So as I am speaking, your avatar and name will also show up, and you can join the voice channel and you can talk with the audience. And along with that, you will get all the perks of the feature role. I mean, sorry, all this of the subscriber role. And so in this, if you subscribe to the subscriber role, you will be able to join the Let's Talk audio channel, and you will be able to listen to the music 24/7. So, and here's the Let's Talk audio channel. You will be able to join this audio channel, and if you want to talk with me or if you need any help regarding anything, I will be happy to help you, and I will try my best to help you out. Maybe you need some help in the coding or in the designing. Anything you want to ask, you can obviously you can also ask me in the text channel, in the journal channel. But if you need to talk with me, you can just join this audio channel and mention me that I want to talk with you. So I will join the audio channel as well, and we can talk. And one thing more I want to mention. So for the subscriber, it costs $2 a month. And if you want, you can even pay more if you want, since the perks will be same, but you can pay more or less as you want, and same goes for the guest role. Okay, I'd be really appreciate that if you could donate a few bucks, it will help me to run the live streams. Okay, so here's the full collection of the logos and other icons. Okay, so we need Facebook, Twitter, and yeah, so basically we need both of them. Let me just copy these icons and paste them over here. Great, so we can just close this. I don't think so, we need any other icon. We don't need any other icon. Okay, so now we just need to we need to set the size to maybe 20 or 22 pixel. Okay, so we will keep the size to 22, and the distance between them will be 30. Okay. We need to change the color of them. So we can do this thing. We will set the background color of this footer, maybe a little bit of bluish, maybe a bit more lighter. Okay, so something like this, we can set the background color of the footer. So I think it's white only. No, I think no, it's not white. Okay, and just decrease the transparency. Okay, that looks good. And now we need to change the color of these also. So we can change the color to maybe a little bit darker. Maybe not so dark. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so it looks good, not bad. But what if we use the original logo color? Just a second, let me put it into a so it is 22x22. Okay, and Twitter. Okay. Okay, so now it looks good. I have added the Twitter logo in a box, and I'll just remove the background color and let me move into it a group and name it as social media. Okay, now let's see it again. Yeah, it looks good, not bad. We need to change the color of this thing, and I need to decrease the size of this also. I can go for 14 pixels. Okay. Okay, so this can work, I suppose. And let me align it to the right, to the left side. And decrease the spacing. 10 pixels would be sufficient, and I also need to decrease the brightness, the darkness of the color. Now I can keep the color around a little bit to the bluish, or I think I should choose some other color palette. Let me get the color palette. Just a second. There was this website where I had, I have bookmarked that website for generating color palettes. Where is that? Okay, random. Or we can say color panel generator. Okay, so let's see this thing. Okay, let's see how it works. It is taking a lot of time. Okay. Not so good. This might be how I can see it. Okay, so now I need to pay, sign on. Okay, I can export it into SVG. Okay, not so bad, but still those colors are, I mean, too dark and these are too bright. If we see from the other perspective, it is okay that we need some kind of a vibrant color and the color should be distinct. How about if we use some kind of a purple theme? That would be also nice. There was this theme in the Visual Studio Code. If you're not familiar with Visual Studio Code, it is a text editor plus IDE. It's an awesome text editor. I have been using it for a while. And in that there was a theme called Shades of Purple, so we can use similar color palette where it would be based on purple color only. Or we can this one also looks good. We can try this. I need SVG. What's this? Copic. Oh, what is this? It's an image. Okay, so let me import this color palette also. So if we compare from this one to this, this looks more nice, or is it good as compared to the consistency of the color and the shades if we compare. Let me try the purple thing. Okay, so the purple is over here. Okay, so this is the purple and need to increase the brightness. Steel pink. Dark magenta and purple. Okay, so here's the purple. Okay, here's the purple. So we can, I think, lock this thing. Yeah, we can lock it. And now let's see if we can get similar colors. If you have any suggestions, do let me know. What is it? You can share the hex code if you have any better suggestion for the colors, or where I can check out the colors or color palette. Okay, I missed it. Can I go back? There was this color, I liked it. I think it was a bluish kind of thing, so it was very nice. Oh, great, that's not responding. Yeah, this one is nice. I like this color. And you can see this color is quite smooth. I like this color. Let me just download the palette only. Okay, export SVG. And okay, so what's next? These are too light. No, this one too light. No, this one also looks good, but I don't like this one. This color, this is this doesn't match these four colors. But yeah, we can also download this one. Not bad. Okay. No. No. So I think we got a bunch of different colors, so we can just choose those one only. We can choose one of them, one of the color palette, and see which one works. Is not downloading. Okay. So I think it will take a lot of time to download. So in the meantime, let me import this color palette. So in this color palette, I only like one color, and I will just pick that color. Rest of them I will delete it. Okay, so just let it be. It's nothing bad to need those colors. Maybe some point of time we might need those colors. Who knows? So let me just rearrange these things. It looks too weird. So we can keep the size 120. Oh great, now it's out of service. I hope it has downloaded the colors. Oh great, and the size is none of the size is different since we need to move this thing. Okay, so now the size is 120. So if we compare these colors, so what do you think, guys? Which color palette we should choose, or should I select some other color palette? I liked this one more or less. Let me try that shades of purple. Purple color palette. So in the meantime, so what do you think, which color palette we should choose? These two color palettes have just a random color palettes, and these two have consistent colors. Just you can say shades are different, but I still like this one. Okay, so we can try the shades of purple thing, how it goes. Not very impressive. Okay, so we can choose color palette. I like this image. Sorry, that was the stool which was falling down. Where's that image? Okay, so here's the image. So I like this one. Yeah, so I liked very much these colors. So these colors are, you can say, more readable, and as compared to this one, as compared to this one, if we use these colors and add text above them, then it is possible that that text might not be readable as compared if we use these color palette. So yeah, we will use this one. Let me get the hex code. Okay, so so just let me copy the color palette, the hex code only. I will just duplicate this one. And copy the hex code. I still don't get it, like, who has invented this hex code? So every you can say digit or every alphabet, no, not alphabet, yeah, every digit in the index hex code represent a different color. How interesting it is. Okay, so here's the last color, and now, so I remember that there was another website for the color palettes, and it was called Color Hunt. So it also has quite awesome color palettes. I just remember recently. Yeah. For example, this one is also very nice. Maybe we can use this one as a call to action color. This one might be the header or footer, or maybe we can use this color for the header and for the call to action, and this color can be used for the header and the footer, and this one for the body text. So they also have good combinations. So let me categorize the color based on likes. Oops. LS new popular 20. Okay. So which one? This one also looks good. You know what, let me submit this color palette. I know someone has created this color palette, but it's good to share this color palette with other people also. Okay, how to copy create palette. I hope I don't have to create account. So we can only select 4 colors. That's not good. That's not good. So let's see how it goes. You know what? I'll leave this color. This looks more good. Yeah. This looks more good. Okay, so let me see the popular ones now. Well, this is a good place to, you know, get some kind of an idea that how we should get started with the colors. This one looks good. Yeah, this one looks good. We can go for this one also. Yeah. So okay, I'll just copy this one also. Since this color has this color palette has only four colors, so we will remove this one of them. And okay, so now so this is all the color palettes we have. I don't want to use this one now. These are nothing as compared to these four, so we can just remove these color palettes. Okay, so these are the color palettes now. You tell which one to use. Okay, here's the chat now. Okay, here's the chat. Okay, so I will keep this this live stream short, and I will just think which color palette to use. And even if you have any suggestions, you can just share them in the chat and let me know which color should I use. And okay, so I will just I will not expand the boundaries. That I will just get I will select any other color palette. Even if I want to select the color, I will just choose any one of these. But I just want to take your opinion also, that which color palette you prefer. And if you have any other suggestions better than me, I'll be happy to consider that also. And so since what you can do, so once I will end the live stream, if you send some kind of a suggestion in the chat, it is possible that I might not be able to read your suggestion or your chat. So what you can do, you can join my Discord server, and share your suggestion and tips over there, that which color palette should I choose, what's your ideas and what do you think, and how we can go further. So I have shared the link of the Discord chat, the Discord server. You can join the server. Okay, so that's this color palette looks very beautiful, and we have to choose any one of these color palettes. So if we think my point of spending so much time on this color palette is that for the brand purpose, choosing a best color palette is very important, that it represents the brand itself. For example, we have created the name of our website in bold, so it should represent the name bold itself, and it should also that the color we are choosing should not affect the user while he or she is reading. Maybe he or she is on the laptop, tablet, maybe on desktop, or even on the mobile phone. So we have to consider all those scenarios and make sure that that we are choosing the best colors. And so if we go for this color palette, these are too dark, too, if you can say a level from high to low, that we have the darker color and little bit lighter and more lighter and more lighter and more lighter. And over here, if we rearrange them, I'm not sure how it will look. I hope I have rearranged them correctly. Okay, so let me just go to space on them. What's the problem in them? They're not getting distributed properly. All of them have equal width. Anyway, so I think I have rearranged these properly. I don't know why they are not getting okay, so that's fine. Okay, so I think now if you see that these colors go from the dark to light, so over here the change is very deep, very steep, that it is going from very dark to lighter, and then again a constant decrease, not constant, the slope is not too steep, and it is going from lighter. But over here we have again the same concept with a darker color and lighter shades of the purple, and this one is totally different, where we have random colors. So we can choose any one of the color palette. Now So that so we will select the color palette and choose that color palette as the brand color of the bold blogging website. And so we'll continue the live stream this designing in the next live stream. And till now, I will see you. Bye bye.